I am Abhi Chalu, and I am a PhD student in Tira Lab. I am working on a project to detect COVID-19 and in the future to also assess disease severity of COVID-19 patients. To detect COVID-19, we use a chest x-ray and blood tests. The application of this system will be in low-income countries where chest x-ray and blood tests are already available in local clinics. But PCR, the test that is used in modern medicine, is not available. A difficulty is that chest x-ray may also not always be available and that every center may measure a slightly different set of blood tests. To overcome this difficulty, I had to build a system that can deal with any combination of missing data and still perform well. Let's dive right into the architecture that I chose after studying the literature. Here is the complete overview. I will go over the elements one by one. This part takes the chest x-ray and inputs it into a convolutional neural network that predicts COVID-19. This is similar to Kaplan COVID x-ray, the product that Tirona developed. I built a system using ResNet-AT pre-trained on ImageNet. First, I retrained this model on the publicly available RSNA pneumonia dataset. Then, I fine-tuned only the last layer of this model using the set of x-rays of COVID-19 suspects from Bernhoven, a hospital in the Netherlands. This gives us a single probability, which we use as an input feature along with our blood test results. In total, we have 27 blood tests. For simplicity, this figure shows a smaller number. We then randomly mask out some input features during training. The idea here is that every time the model sees the data from a patient, it sees a different subset of inputs. By doing this, we train a system that can perform well with any subset of the 27 blood tests and chest x-ray. Now, we encode these features in a hidden layer. We track different settings here. Previous literature, a publication from 2010 by Vincent et al. From the group of Joshua Bengio, suggested you should use a small number of features in the encoding layer to get good results. We made alternative choices that turned out to work much better. From this encoding layer, we can directly predict the probability of a positive diagnosis of COVID-19. And then we are done. But since we have this encoder, we can also introduce a second objective during training, namely to also predict the values of the missing or masked out input features. It turns out that by teaching the network to do this additional task, it becomes better at diagnosing COVID-19. The results are very encouraging. Here is a plot summarizing the experiments I did with the data from Bernhoven Hospital for training and data from your Wash Hospital, another Dutch hospital, for testing. Both sets had data from around 500 patients. First, I have to explain I used another well-known classifier, random forest, as a baseline. I trained random forest with complete feature sets and with input masking, so subsets, like I did for the neural network. I also trained all variants of the network with and without input masking. All the dashed lines are results without the input masking. You can see input masking is important to get good results. All the dashed lines are much lower. We plot here on the y-axis area under the curve. That is the standard metric for performance for such tests. If this value is 0.5, it means random guessing, and 1 means perfect classification. We plot the area under the ROC curve as a function of the number of input features available at test time. What is plotted is the average of a very large number of random subsets of input features that I took. For example, here you see how the models perform when 15 of the 28 input features are available. As I said, higher is better. The red curve is the network I proposed. It works best. I call it DFCN, denoising fully connected network. But if you do not train it with input masking, the red dashed line does not work well at all. The blue line is denoising autoencoder, as proposed in Vincent et al. In publication from 2010. The purple line is a simplified version of the denoising autoencoder, the system from Vincent et al. This model used a context training procedure.
because at the time of the study, they could not optimize the network using GPUs. Such a training procedure allowed the training of networks at the time, but it resulted in a model that did not perform that well. FCM, the green line, is what you get when you leave out the reconstruction of the mask input values. You see, the network does not learn its task as well if you omit this extra term in the loss function. The random forest classifier is the orange line. Note that with all blood values and the chest X-ray, we reach 0.925 area under the curve. That is very good performance. This network also allows us to measure which subset of blood values will work well. Based on that, we have selected 5 blood values that we can measure quickly without the need of special laboratory equipment. In this setting, 2 blood test machines are sufficient. Together with mobile X-ray machines, this will be operational in clinics in Lesotho, in South Africa, and probably in Zambia and Uganda. This is really a team effort. This project is funded by a research foundation, by a Swiss research foundation, the Botnar Foundation. A big consortium for many NGOs has been set up in a matter of only months. Thanks to that imaging and support from Open Road Alliance, we are able to provide clinics in Lesotho with X-ray units that they can also use for other purposes. Tirola makes sure CAT for COVID and my new model will run on the hardware in Africa. Our colleagues from clinical chemistry in Den Bosch and Van Hoven helped us with the data and gave advice on which blood markers we should use. We will now collect new data from those clinics in Africa to retrain my system with data from a population where not only COVID-19, but also tuberculosis and HIV are commonly seen. What I really like is that I was able to build a practical application of robust machine learning only in a few months, and we will now field test it in Africa immediately.